Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. Glad to have you here like always. In today's video, we're gonna be DNA sexing some of the birds that we have back here. Now you may be asking yourself, why is it that you have to DNA sex birds, or how is it that you DNA sex birds? Well, the reason that we DNA sex them is to find out, obviously, the sex. Some of these species, like for example, the Rosellas that we're gonna be DNA sexing today, are monomorphic, meaning that they come in one form. The males and the females look identical, so it can be very difficult for the untrained eye to notice subtle differences between the sexes. And with parrots, one of the things that we don't have on our side is time. These birds can take years to develop sexually, so the last thing that you want to do is go through 1 or 2 years of holding what you think are a pair of birds and end up with 2 males or 2 females, and you come to find this out when it comes time to breed and they either lay too many eggs or they never lay any eggs at all. So in order to avoid those problems, what I like to do is as soon as I get the birds, DNA sex them. That way I know if they're a pair or if I have to go out and find them the suitable mates. All right, so here are our patients for today. We have these beautiful Eastern Rosellas, and these guys right here are normal coloration. And then on top, we have the fiery opalines or fury, depending on how some people call them. And for these guys, I'm not sure exactly if they're a pair, if they're males, if they're females. For these right here, the normals, I've heard both of them singing, so I'm starting to think that I have 2 males with these guys, and I'm gonna go ahead and show you guys a clip from a friend of mine that showed me what the male song sounds like. Now these 2 up here have not done anything. I haven't heard any singing, but they are young, so I'm thinking maybe that might be a pair. Either ways, we're gonna DNA sex them. And this is the things that you're gonna need in order to DNA sex your birds. You're gonna need a sample card. Now for the sample card, I got these from Bird IQ Testing or IQ Bird Testing. This is the company that I'm gonna be using today in order to get the results for the DNA sex of these birds. There's a variety of different companies. This is not a paid promotion whatsoever. This is just the one or one of the ones that I use on many occasions. You're gonna need some alcohol pads in order to clean your utensils between testing, because the last thing that you wanna do is have have your utensil, for example this, which I'm gonna use to clip the nail of one bird, it's gonna get blood on it, and then you clip another nail and now you've just tainted the other blood sample. So you need alcohol pads in order to clean what you're using to cut your nails. The last thing that you are going to need is some sort of wound gel or wound seal, blood stop, blood whatever, one of these things that stops bleeding. Because after you cut the bird's toenail, after you get the sample of blood, you want to apply this gel to their toes so that it doesn't continue bleeding. What we're gonna do is we're gonna start with the top cage. Now, unfortunately, that top cage, I have to pull the whole entire thing down in order to access the birds, because I can't, because of the roof and how close it is to the roof, I can't open the door all the way through. Now, the way that I'm gonna be catching these birds are with a net. It's gonna be the easiest way, that way I don't hurt them, it's less stressful for them, it's a little bit quicker, catch them, clip the nails, and move on. So let's get that cage down. Once I catch the birds, I like to leave them in the net. This is gonna avoid them using their beak to bite or anything like that. And you have, and then you have easy access to their toes. One of the things that you're gonna need in order to fill out the card is obviously looking at their band, their band number, and all that stuff that you need to get the identification. But I'll show you that later on. Let's go ahead and clip the toenail. All right, so we clipped the nail, we applied the wound gel to stop the bleeding, and now once you do that, you go ahead and use some sort of swab or anything that you can grab, a piece of a cloth, Bounty, whatever it is, and just kind of hold the wound together for a good 10, 15, 20 seconds until it seals up, and then you can go ahead and put the bird back in the cage. And this is what it's gonna look like. All you need is 2 to 3 drops in the little circle right there in the center. It's kind of hard to get this to focus, but all you need is a couple little drops in the center. Then you put the bird ID, the band number that it has, and it's easier for you to identify. There's a couple other things that you have to fill out, like, for example, the species, the owner, your email and phone number. And then this is what you're going to send out in order to get them DNA sexed. Now, once this is fully filled out, I'm going to stick it inside of the Ziploc bag. Let's go ahead and disinfect the clippers that I used to cut the nail, and let's go ahead and do the other bird as well. Let me show you guys this. This is exactly why you have to clean your pliers or your nail clippers or anything before you use it on the next bird. You can see that drop of blood right there. That can contaminate your next sample. So make sure after you cut the bird's nail to get the blood sample, you grab an alcohol pad and you clean the tool that you're using to cut that nail very, very good. Because the last thing that you want is a little drop of blood contaminating the other sample. Sometimes this is a little bit easier when you have some help. I'm having a bit of a hard time holding the bird in one hand, clipping the nail in the other, applying the wound care. So if you have somebody that can help you while doing this, it would make things so much easier than you having to do it by yourself. But the concept is easy. You clip the toenail, you put two drops of blood on that little piece of paper, you disinfect the thing that you used to cut the nail of bird number one, then you go ahead, you apply wound care, seal up the wound, hold it for 10, 15 seconds, put that bird back, repeat the process with the next bird. Ooh, he almost got out. So we got all the blood samples that we needed from the pairs. Here they are right here. One of the things that you want to do after you put them back into their cage is look at the perches where they're standing on. Is there any blood on the perches? If you notice that there's blood on the perches, you want to go ahead and pull the bird back out again and apply some of that, the bleeding stop, in order to stop that process. Now, one last thing, once you get the blood on the sample card, make sure that you wait a little bit for that blood right there to dry up. The last thing that you want to do is put it inside of the Ziploc bag. As you can see, these are already in the Ziploc bags, but I made a mistake with this one. The blood was still a little bit wet, and you can see how it kind of smeared onto the bag. So make sure that it dries up first, then put it in your Ziploc bag. All right, guys, well, this is going to be the end of the video. I hope that this tutorial was helpful for some of you who may have been a bit scared or wondering how it was that you DNA sex the birds, or how do you collect those samples to DNA sex the birds. I hope that this was useful for you guys. It's a stressful thing for you as a breeder. It's a stressful thing for the birds, but it's something that needs to get done in order to have better outcomes in the future. Like always, if you've enjoyed the video, remember to hit a thumbs up, like, and subscribe, and we'll see each other in the next video. Bye.